Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Camera Tuesday. Today we're gonna take a look at how to boost your DSLR which you have already purchased. So let's dive right into it. First thing you have to understand, please read the damn manual. Every camera company is unique. Canon, the skill set that you need for Canon camera is not the same as skill set you need for Nikon camera. And even if you know how to handle a Canon camera, each model is also unique. Of course, there is a lot of general overlap, and camera manufacturers try their best to make sure that if you know how to handle one Canon camera, you can handle any camera. However, there are still a lot of unique features that are specifically, you know, dedicated to that camera. For that reason, please read the damn manual. And one very crucial fact, you already have it. Your camera most likely already came with it, like as in physical copy. So read it, like, and there are many buttons in your camera that you do not know of, like many hidden features that you may not know the location of. Like, you may have read like this camera has time-lapse feature. Where is it? Like, it may be buried under a menu. To find that, you have to, like, you know, read the manual. And this sort of information you cannot get on YouTube. Like, if you, let's say for my camera Canon 800D, I go to find out how to do time-lapse, they're gonna show me how to do time lapse, but they're not gonna tell the condition applied to it, which a manual has. A manual will tell you, okay, it can only take 3600 shots, or like it can only extend to 4 hours, or things of that nature. Basically, the reason why we say devil is in the detail, it has all of it. Please go through your manual. It's compulsory, and you will be thankful that you did afterwards. Put proper memory card. Now, I cannot tell you how frustrating it is to handle a DSLR, a good DSLR, which has a shitty SD card into it. The card they give you, that 8GB card generally give you, keep that in your camera bag as an emergency. Like, your primary card failed, or like, you know, your primary card is full, but you do not want to spend time deleting everything. Just put that card in, but do not use that. That's a last resort. That's the cheapest card they can send you, and still call it, you know, capable of handling a DSLR. Now, as I said, read the manual. Manual also comes with a specific list of what kind of SD cards, what manufacturers, what type has been tested with the camera, or at least is in what's called qualified vendor list. So, like, if you are not sure of the company whether it will work with your camera or not, just read it. Like, many cameras don't support Samsung cards, and people are like, you know, they bought good Samsung card. Nothing fault with the card, it's just not working properly with their system. So for this sort of reason, please read the manual's list. And you have to understand, first thing in an SD card that you have to pay attention to is the speed. Like, I'm showing you some very, very high speed cards. These are like 300 Mbps cards. And this is UHSM-1 structure, and this is UHSM-2 structure. Now, UHS-2 structure basically has extra pins, so of course it's not backwards compatible. You can put this card in a older card reader and camera, but you will not get that extra speed. To get that extra speed, you need to have connector pins for this. Now, many times photographers still buy this even if their camera only supports this, for simple reason. Like, let's say you have a card like 128GB card, you want to make sure you dump that information to your computer very quickly. And this is why I'm specifying, please get a USB 3.0 card reader. Like, even when I'm shooting a full HD video 60 frames per second, the file size are easily going to 4 or 5 GB. You don't want to, like, you know, sit around, yeah, what are you doing? Yeah, I'm just transferring files. So please get a USB 3.0 card reader. Your experience of using your DSLR is directly proportional on these two things. So get a good card, first check the speed, then check the capacity, because not every DSLR can handle the biggest card you can throw at it. Like, many cameras, old cameras specifically, cannot handle 128GB, some cannot handle 256GB. So please read the manual and you will find this information. So first thing you check is speed. Like, don't go overboard unless you want to use faster card readers. And like, if you have UHSM-1, just use UHSM-1/2. If you're not, use UHSM-2. And you get the speed down, then you get the capacity. Bigger is always better, simply because you really don't want to be in a scenario where you are just emptying out your card. And format. Now, this format, you don't have to worry that much, but still pay attention to it. Some old, specifically old DSLRs might flat out say, like, they won't support SDX XC cards. Like, there are many versions of these cards that you have to be mindful of. So check speed first, check capacity second, check the format last. And please get a USB 3.0 cartridge. Otherwise, like your 128 GB card will take way too long to unload. Now, all the DSLR shots do not magically become good because they have like, you know, good sensor or things like that. You have to put two things to it, time and stability. Specifically, if you are taking photos of anything like, you know, large, like buildings or scenery or things of that nature. So use some sort of tripod, monopod or string pod. Basically, string pod is like you put a nut in your camera and you just tie a string and use your foot to lock down. This is called a tension tripod. Tripod is not correct word, but basically you would be surprised how much shake you can remove from your system just by using that string. And string you can put in your pocket and you can carry it anywhere. So, and you can build it at your home. It will barely cost you $2 to $5. So suffice to say, you can easily do this. You can't carry tripod or even a monopod everywhere, but you can carry that thing everywhere. So use that, like please use that, and put some time into your shot. Like take your shot, review it, take another shot. Like just don't have like, it's not a machine gun. Take your time and look at the photo afterwards and you'll be like, yeah, I could have like, you know, recomposed it like this. So please take your time. Time and stability will directly improve your image quality, and as your consequence, your experience of using your own DSLR would be much better. Now, for starter peoples, I generally recommend go with RAW plus JPEG as file save. Why? Now, first very simple issue is, if you use RAW, it gives you a lot of processing room when you are doing in Lightroom or any other kind of other software. Like, because it's not compressing the data, you can apply better noise reduction, you can apply better compression, so the final print file that you're gonna get out of it, which can be JPEG or PNG or any other format, you will get much better quality out of it. Then RAW nowadays can be processed on your Android phone also. So these are two applications, Photoshop Express and Snapseed, which is owned by Google. So you can now even process your RAW files directly on your phone. So you have no excuse of not using RAW. And JPEG, the reason why I'm saying JPEG is, like, let's say you accidentally formatted your card or deleted the file. Recovering RAW takes much longer and not always guaranteed, simply because nobody can write a software that can detect RAW. There is no .RAW. Every camera has its own format. That creates a hell of a headache. That's why if you have JPEG, you can recover it. And this is just a demo that I'm showing, where you can have, I will put the demo in full scale here. As you can see, there is a lot of room. Of course, you may like the artsy kind of photo, you may not like it, but you have the headroom if you use RAW. So this was my small little presentation about how to boost your DSLR. I hope you liked it or learned from it. In that case, please like. If you didn't, dislike and leave a comment what would you like to see next. And as always, subscribe and press the bell icon. I make video every day. And as always, thanks for watching.